KPM.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, up the ladder. Wow, now I'm number 44. Okay, hi everybody, good morning. You guys are watching Terasa Didik TV KPM. My name is Nisa K and I'll be with you guys for today's episode or today's class. This is very exciting because I'm playing this snake and ladder and it's back on Teras. By the way, I would like to remind you guys that we are still fighting this pandemic. Always wear your face mask if you need to go out or not. Just stay at home to take care of yourself and maintain a physical distance of at least 1 meter or more. Wash your hands frequently using water and soap and using hand sanitizer when needed. So what are we going to learn today, or are we just going to play? Well, to know who is the teacher that will be with us today, let's watch her profile. Okay. One. Everybody, let's welcome Madam Farah Liza. Hi, Madam.
Hi.
Good morning.
Good morning, Nisa.
How are you doing?
Alhamdulillah, I'm doing well. Thank you, Nisa. It's so great to meet you again.
Yes, I'm so excited because
whenever I
see you, I know that something's going to happen in this studio today.
Yes.
And this is Miss Madam Farah Liza, I'm sorry, from SMK Bandar Mas Kota Tinggi, Johor. So today, obviously, we're going to learn English together. But before that, I have some friends that would like to join our class today.
Yes.
This is very exciting. So where's my friends? Hi. Good morning.
So the girls team now.
Yes. Before we start our class, and I'll be asking Madam Farah, what are we going to learn today? Let's ask our friends to introduce themselves so that our friends at home know them better. So we will start with Iriani. Kindly introduce yourself.
Thank you, Ms. Nisa. Hi, everyone. My name is Iriani Nasrin and I'm from Sekolah Menengah Sains Tuanku Jaafar, Negeri Sembilan.
Thank you, Iriani.
W-E-L-C-O-M-E. Welcome!
Yay!
Thank you. So energetic.
I'm loving this.
Yes. Today in the house.
Okay, next, we are going with Nicole. Kindly introduce yourself.
Thank you, Ms. Nisa. Hi, everyone. My name is Nicole Ong Suchi, and I'm from Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan Putra Perdana Selangor.
H-E-L-L-O. Hello.
Hello, everyone.
So much fun. Okay, next, we'll proceed with Sharifah.
Hello there, everyone. My name is Sharifah Lukna, and I'm from Bandaraya Girls' School, Kuala Lumpur.
Hi, Sharifah.
Okay, next we have Alia.
Thank you, Ms. Nisa. Assalamualaikum and hi, everyone. My name is Nurul Batisha Alia. You can call me Alia. And I'm from Sekolah Agama Menengah, Payung Jaras, Selangor.
W-E-L-C-O-M-E. Welcome.
Thank you.
Okay, after Alia, we have Sarah. Kindly introduce yourself.
Hi, everyone. My name is Sarah Binti Basir Ahmad, and I'm from Sri Aman Girls' School, Petaling Jaya.
H-E-L-L-O.
Hello. Thank you, Sarah. Last but not least, Madam Farah, we have Fatin.
Thank you, Ms. Nisa. To all my friends out there, my name is Fatin Amira. I am from Sekolah Berasrama Penuh Integrasi Gombak.
Hi.
Thank you so much. So we have friends from 6 different schools.
Yes.
And they are all very energetic and
super.
I feel very warm meeting them. Oh, I'm so excited for today's class.
Girls' energy.
Girls' power for today's episode. So now, before I ask what are we going to learn today, I would like to invite you to sanitize your hand first. And I have mine here. Mine is quite small size.
Okay.
Okay. Together we sanitize our hands before we do any activities. Oh, okay. It's okay. All right. So, Madam Farah, what are we going to learn today? It seems that you bring quite you know, new things in the set.
Inshallah. Okay, thank you, Nisa. All right. Nisa, if you notice our previous notes, we have already covered mom, Miss or Match.
Yes, Miss or Match.
So I feel this is about time for us to start exposing them on dad and how this dad and mom work together. All right. So for our today's lesson, we are going to expose our friends out there on the dad, which is decide and drive. Yeah. So I'll be also sharing you the slides for now. Okay. So we are going to do some baby steps, definitely. But this time it's going to be a little bit in depth because we are not only producing separated sentences, but we're going to combine all the sentences and come up with one beautiful, strong paragraph.
Okay, I cannot wait to learn together, and I hope our friends at home are already. Just prepare your pen, pencil or paper and just to take some notes for today's lesson.
Yes.
We'll be taking a break a little bit, and I'll see you guys after this in Teras Didik TV KPM.
See you soon!
Do you want to know how technology changed my life? Well, let's check it out. With technology, I will no longer need to flip thousands of pages. Instead, I just Google. I can now say goodbye to paper and pen and say hello to the nature friendly using the apps. However, when there is pros, there is cons. So how do I make sure that I'm not way too obsessed with the gadget? Well, it's a piece of cake. My mom already added me in the family link, so she can observe what I do with my smartphone and set a time limit and how much I can spend my time on the phone. So guys, having the technology to make life easier is okay, but don't get too obsessed. And that's how technology changed my life. How about yours?
Didik TV KPM. Didik TV KPM.
My name is Muhammad Syafiq Mat Samari. Today, I will share with you about the positivity of the technology. Let's go.
First, you can access to the content on unlimited number of times, just like this. Second, it's be able to become more efficient educators, just like this. You can learn about the chemical reaction on YouTube. But if you misuse your technology, you will become like this.
Okay guys, remember, you are what your mind says.
You are what your mind says?
Exactly, you are what your mind says.
Welcome back to Teras. So we are now learning English and the theme is High tech world.
Yes.
Okay, so I'm so excited because today we are going to integrate the mom and the dad. Mom is MOM, mix or match, and dad is DAD, decide and drive.
Exactly. Wow, you're so good. Excited. A plus for you, Nisa. A plus for you.
But before that, I would like to ask our friends on Google Meet, are you guys ready for today's lesson? If you guys are ready, give me a double thumbs up. Yay! They are already very energetic, and I hope our friends at home ready as well. So let's proceed with our lesson, Madam Bora.
Okay, thank you, Nisa. All right, girls and boys viewers out there. So today we are about to go to another unit.
Delivery.
Nisa.
Delivery. Okay, okay.
I didn't expect that to arrive here.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you, dear.
Thank you.
Oh, you have already unboxed it for me. Thank you.
Oh, the delivery girl is very beautiful.
Yeah.
Okay.
So Nisa, I'm so excited.
Wow, what
so
is that?
This is actually a professional condenser microphone that I've ordered from one of the online platforms.
Oh, wow.
And of course, this is about technology and you bought this also online. So it is also in line with the technology.
Yes. Madam, what does it do? This condenser microphone?
Yeah, definitely it saves your it actually gives your strength to speak better, to sound better, and it avoids myself from having any sore throat.
Yeah.
Because for teachers out there, they'll be like glued on the screen, having their PTPR sessions, and I'm sure all teachers need this.
Yes.
Thanks to technology, Nisa.
Yes, thanks to technology.
Oh,
we can
so
actually
excited.
Buy things from outside Malaysia, and it arrives like just in time. We are in Teras. Okay.
Okay, all right, Nisa. So let's get back to our business here. So today we are going to explore another next unit that is on High Tech World, and you guys can turn to page 109 of your textbook. And today we are going to focus on using by and with, as well as collocations. All right. Now, what are actually collocations? Well, I'll explain to you later. All right. Now, these are the pages. So please take note, girls and boys. Open up this page, and we'll see more to explore new things. Okay. Now, Nisa, our objective for today, I have two objectives today,
okay,
which are, firstly, to organize, sequence, and develop ideas within short text on familiar topics. Now, before this class, Nisa, I've already given them a topic for them to read through,
okay,
so that they have some ideas, previous knowledge, so that they can respond in our today's lesson.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And my second objective is the complementary skill, which is to produce a plan or draft 2 paragraphs or more, and modify this appropriately as well as independently. So when I say produce a plan or draft, that mm-hmm. is where the dad and mom come along very well.
Okay?
So for everyone, I'm going to tell you what collocations mm-hmm. are. Now, most of us, they are not aware that they are using this in everyday life. But they never know that collocations are actually when two words get together.
Mm-hmm.
There's like word plus word. I love to give formulas so that students can see clearer.
Yes.
There's like a combination of two words. All right. Now, it can be a verb plus a noun. For example, pay internet bills. Hello. Mm-hmm. We are in the high-tech world.
Yes.
We definitely have to pay bills, internet bills. Right. Okay. Now, it's another example, adjective plus noun. For example, cheap tablet.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Sometimes we can't afford to buy mm-hmm. some expensive tablets out there.
Yes.
But we can always opt for cheap tablets.
Yes.
As long as they can go through their PDPR mm-hmm. successfully.
We have a lot of options.
Exactly. So that is one of the examples for collocations. And on top of that, we have verb plus prepositions. Now, we can also say it as a phrasal verb.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We have shut and also down. That mm-hmm. is also considered as collocations. Last but not least is adjective plus prepositions. For example, disappointed with. So when we have these two combinations, Nisa, mm-hmm. now this falls under collocations. And last but not least, today we're going to focus on how to apply by and also with mm-hmm. in our sentence. Okay, Nisa. Mm-hmm. So today we are going to focus on our second segment, that is that.
Mm-hmm.
Now, if before this mom means mix or match,
yes.
So that is decide and drive.
Decide and drive.
Now, why do we need to decide? It's just like when we go for a vacation, Nisa.
Ah.
For example, let me just ask maybe Fatin. Okay,
okay,
Fatin. Now, please answer my question. Now, if your father plans to have a vacation, now what would you choose? A 3-day, 2 nights vacation or a 1 week vacation? Which one is your choice?
1 week.
Fatin.
Of course, 1 week, madam.
Yes.
Ah, okay. Why 1 week, Fatin? Why? What is the reason?
Because I want to have a long holiday.
Yes, long holidays means more activities,
yes.
more places to visit.
Mm-hmm.
So same goes to essay writing, Nisa.
Mm-hmm.
When we decide on the number of paragraphs, the more paragraphs we have, it gives you more ideas.
Okay.
And it gives you more marks to impress your examiners.
Mm-hmm.
Now, let's say if you go for a holiday for 5 days.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what is the effect, Nicole? What is the immediate fast effect that you will get if you spend for a vacation for 5 days?
We are going to spend a lot of money, madam.
Spot on. You're going to spend a lot of money. So same goes to writing essays.
Yes, longer vacations,
yeah,
more
longer
money
vacation
to be spent
needs
on.
More money. Yeah. Longer essay needs more time.
Mm-hmm.
So if your father plans to go for a vacation, so your father needs to start saving money.
Yes.
So same mm-hmm. goes to writing essay. So you have to start practicing so that you can save your time to kill that 30 minutes on time to complete your essay.
Interesting.
So that is how I try to link this with our reality on writing.
Mm-hmm.
So in our that segment, decide and drive. Why drive, Nisa? Because mm-hmm. you are going to drive us teachers to a beautiful park.
Yes.
Or to a dumping site.
No.
touch wood. It will never happen. Okay. Now, the first part is we are going to decide and drive. And the second part is we are going to represent one idea. Because mm-hmm. one paragraph represents one idea, Nisa. Okay? And the third part is we are going to generate the questions. Now, when I say questions, all students will be, madam, this must definitely be the 5W1H, right?
Yes,
madam?
The what, why,
yes.
when,
okay,
how.
Now you say it's very common.
Mm-hmm.
But why are students now unable to write a good essay if mm-hmm. they know this very well? So this is the time where you need to go beyond the level to explore more on what that does in your writing.
Okay.
So the third part is to generate questions. So that is what our friends are going to do today. And they need to choose only one question.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, girls and boys, for that decide and drive, we actually have 9. Remember your lucky numbers, 6 and 9?
Yes.
6 is for mom, 9 is for dad.
Yeah.
But because we have our time constraint, I'm not able to share everything with you.
Mm-hmm.
But we're just going to choose maybe 2 or 3 out of the 9 idea keys.
Okay.
All right. So now this is what happens. For that one, okay, now I'm going to give you an example very quickly. So we're going to write one question. So let's say I choose who.
Mm-hmm.
So the question will be, or maybe why, or we're going to decide either why or who today.
Mm-hmm.
All right, this is one example. So you just write the question in the bubble. So the bubble represents that. If there is a bubble, there is a that there.
Mm-hmm.
So who will have problems in online learning? Or maybe you can say, who will never miss online learning?
Mm-hmm.
Or perhaps you can ask, who needs to help us if we have internet issues? So when you look at all these questions, you have to remember, girls and boys, do not write question with the same idea. Do you understand what it means? It means you must feel that, oh, madam, my question is the different way of questioning.
Mm-hmm.
But when you go to the answer, you will have the same answer with two different questions.
Now I get it. Okay.
Now, which leads to a monotonous pattern of writing.
Mm-hmm.
And that will affect your language ban.
Ah,
okay? So when you look here, so Anissa, this is actually the whole playground of your mind.
Mm-hmm.
So this is your mind. And you will have 4 paragraphs. Why 4 paragraphs, girls and boys?
Mm-hmm.
Because PT3 students, they are going to have 2 parts of essays.
Mm-hmm.
So maximum is 4, but they can always reach to 5 paragraphs. But it's all about timing.
Betul.
So paragraphs, so let's say they can choose why, they can choose who, they can choose what, and they can choose if will. So if will is like what I have improvised for my dad. So they write the question in the bubble, like what I've shown you in the slide.
Right.
All right. Mm-hmm. So next, what they need to do is today, we are going to talk about technology and it's all about maybe a different topic. Yeah. So this is what I have explained to you earlier. All right. Remember, do not write questions with the same idea. So reminder to all of you girls. Yeah. Okay. So let us start. So today we are going to ask them. Okay.
Why?
Before. Okay. Mm-hmm. Now. Let us ask them to choose, yeah?
Okay.
So we have why, we have who, we have what, and we have so many other 5WH questions, Nisa.
Mm-hmm.
So let us ask the girls to decide what will be your choice before we start and proceed our that.
Ah.
So what's your choice? Anyone?
Who wants to go first?
Madam!
Yes,
yes,
but,
Alia.
Alia. Yes, Alia. So what's your choice, Alia?
I choose W-H-Y.
Okay.
Why?
Why?
So they choose why. Okay. So let's say our topic for today, Nisa, is online shopping, which is a new norm, which I feel is in line with our topic on high-tech world.
Yes.
Let us just be realistic, Nisa. Mm-hmm. We talk about the reality.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So this is about perhaps the topic is online shopping, which is a new norm.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So we have to spin the wheel, Nisa.
Okay.
And we're going to choose.
It's time for the wheel to get in action.
Yes, it's time for the wheel, Nisa. Spin the wheel, Nisa.
I'm going to spin the wheel now. Spin the wheel.
Let it be big. Let it be big. Let it be big, Nisa.
Big numbers.
Big number. Wang besar. Wang besar. Wang besar.
Oh,
I miss Halim Uthman. All right. Okay.
Oh.
So that's 6.
No. No.
Make it stop. Okay, 2. All right. So we have 2 of that. So we have 1. 2. All right. So let me have the one in white. So who is wearing the white hijab? Oh, they are wearing different color team. Okay. Alia, can you please give me your choice of question?
Thank you, madam. So my dad is why. And my question will be, why is online shopping better?
All right. Why is online shopping better? Okay, Nisa, the first tip for today.
Mm-hmm.
When you want to decide your paragraph, make sure you ask questions which you understand the most.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you understand, you can elaborate well.
Mm-hmm. So something that we can relate.
Yes, something that you can relate to yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So when you talk about that, you don't talk about the colors.
Mm-hmm.
You just talk about the 9 idea keys.
Mm-hmm.
And Alia's question was, why is online
better?
Shopping
is better.
Mm-hmm. So, all right. So this is for... Alia. Okay, better. Now, let's go to the next one.
Okay, nuts number. Make it big, please. Magic wheels.
Okay, all right.
Seven.
Okay, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's green color. Nisa, what is green color, Nisa?
Okay,
Nisa?
Green color. Oh. I think, wait, is Sarah or Irene is wearing green? I can't tell.
I think it's Sarah, green color.
Okay, Sarah.
Okay,
what is your question?
Thank you, madam. My dad is why? My question is, why do people tend to get addicted to online shopping?
Alamak,
why do people tend to get addicted?
It's like a slap on my face. Okay,
yes,
very good.
I feel attacked.
Why do people get addicted? Well, I think I'm on the way to be addicted now.
Okay,
okay, that's good. Sarah, good job. Okay, now let's go to the next one.
Next one. Next number.
Okay, those are two questions generated from the question why. Yeah? Okay, the next one will be?
12.
Wow, that's 12. A big number. So let us count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So the lady in blue. Mm-hmm. Who is the lady in blue? I can't see the difference
Irene.
Of this hijab's color. Yeah, is that you, Irene? I think Irene is wearing
blue.
Yes, okay. So what's your choice, Irene?
Thank you, madam. My dad is why, and my question is, why is online shopping easier?
Okay. Easier is a good choice. And we have addicted, better and easier. All right. Good job, Irene.
Going to spin.
Okay. Spin the wheel. Spin the wheel. Okay.
Spin the wheel. Big numbers, please.
12, please. 12.
12 again. No, no. Oops.
Oh, 12. Yes.
Okay.
So we're going to have 12. 1, 2, come on, girls, let's count together. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So it's blue, so we skip to the next one. That is your favorite color, Lisa.
Yes, yellow.
Yellow. So the lady in yellow.
14.
All right. 14, what's
Thank
your choice?
Thank you, madam. My dad is why, and my question is, why does online shopping cost more than what in shopping?
I never knew that.
More?
Oh, just now somebody said cheaper or easier.
Ah.
Oh, why is it more expensive, Fatin? Can you explain? Now I'm confused.
It includes delivery charge, madam.
Oh, because of the delivery charge.
So it will be like plus 10 ringgit or 12 ringgit perhaps.
Yes,
very good. So it's more expensive. Good job, Fatin. Okay, go to the next one, Isa.
Okay, expensive. I'm going to spin the wheel once again, but before that, we are going to take 5. And I'll see you guys after this on Teras at Didik TV KPM.
See you soon.
Assalamualaikum and hi. My name is Nur Balkis Binti Muhammad Yassin and I'm from SMK Bandar Mas. Today, I'm going to share with you about online learning.
Nowadays, online learning is becoming a hot topic during this coronavirus pandemic. First, online learning offers the students a more comfortable environment as they feel the comfort of their own home.
Besides, the learning session can be recorded and students can watch it again for reference.
Online class is also flexible for students as it allows students to attend online classes from any locations. However, online class is not always efficient for students to catch up.
They will forget on how to socialize with people as they are lack of communication skills.
Students can also easily lose their focus on screen as they will easily get distracted by social media or even video games. That's all from me. Thank you.
Didik TV KPM. Didik TV KPM.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Muhammad Syed Asmat Berhanapi. Today, I will share to all of you about benefit for students of using technology. The benefits, students can develop a deeper understanding in their study and that technology can take a keen interest in our learning to students because they easy to share the information. Or technology can ease to store our information in an easy way. Next. next, family must keep an eye on their children when using technology like gadget for avoid abuse in using technology. I hope this information can give you guys a new knowledge about technology.
Welcome back to Teras at Didik TV KPM, everybody in the class now. Okay, so we are still with Madam Farah and our friends from six different schools, and so far we have learned that collocations are word plus word, like verbs and noun, adjective and nouns. Verb and preposition?
Yes.
Adjective and preposition?
Yes. Okay. My A+ today.
And we know what that is, which is decide and drive. Exactly. So we have the questions. And what are we going to learn next, Madam Farah?
The next part is they are going to experience how to write the sentence.
Okay.
So now we are going to have that magic of that and how it works well in their sentence using mom as well.
Using mom as
well. All right. Okay. We shall start. So for our third segment, girls and boys, all viewers out there, for our third segment, we are going to write a sentence, but please bear in mind, we are going to include the colours in the sentence. So basically, girls and boys, this is a secret to all of you that I will reveal.
Oh.
A good sentence has three colours, Lisa. That is how they grow their sentence to become a complex quality sentence.
Okay.
All right. Now, the first step is they have to, of course, start with VA in our previous lessons. I'm sure you remember that. So VA stands for your mom and your colors. The next part is you are going to include your conjunctions, which is very basic. And of course, you're going to also combine with your adverb. Last but not least, if I have another two more, it will be including your phrasal verb, which is also part of collocations.
Yes.
All right. Adverbs can also be part of collocations, as well as E, that is your RP. What is that? Relative pronoun. Okay. So when we have all this, we are going to include all this VA, CJ, adverb, adjective, SA, PV, and RP. I just love symbols and formulas. Okay. Now, girls and boys, please, I'm going to give you an example. This is how the magic works, and you need to draft your essay before you ever write one. So the first one, all right? Let me just give you this. Now, when you look at the bubble, that represents your dad. Now, if you notice, I started with VA1. That is to answer the question. So whatever question that you write here, Nisa, it has to be answered by VA1.
Okay.
So VA1 answers the question. And next will be VA5. Or VA6, it's up to them. So VA6 will be the so what of VA1. So VA5 will be the so what. I'll explain to you later.
Okay.
I'm sure all of you like in the middle of like, what is this? All right. So there goes your colors. Yeah, you see, I have yellow, I have red, and I also have green. Madam, what color is this? This is purple, not in the least. Now, VA1, Nisa, has no specific colours.
Okay.
It can be white, it can be green, it can be red, it can be black, it can be any of the six colours as long as it answers the question. Okay, so now let us begin. All right, now I'm going to give you an example. All right, so this is your step one, step two, step three, step four, and step five, and you'll be using your VA form. So step two is the so what of VA1. So you have to end what you have started. Okay, so this is how it works. All right, let's say I'm going to ask a question about me.
Okay.
Just talk about me. It's easier for you to understand. Who is Madam Farah Liza? So I am using who.
Who?
So this is my answer. Is a mother of five heroes. Now, this is how VA5 works. So if Madam has five heroes, what will happen? So this will be the answer. We'll always be thankful. So VA5 will conclude your VA1.
Ah.
So when you start, you have to end it with your VA5. So the next one is yellow. What is yellow, Nisa? Positive.
Positive.
So what positive things can Madam Farah do? Shares her skills. And for red color, what is red color, Nisa?
Red color, wait. I tried to remember. Can anyone help me?
Okay, girls, what is red color for?
Nicole, what is red color stand for?
Feelings and emotions.
I know, I just
want
to ask you.
How do I feel, Nisa? Of course, it's excited. It's always excited to be with my students. And last but not least is green color. Girls, what is green color, girls? What is green color?
ideas and suggestions.
Yes, ideas and suggestions. So what would I suggest? So I would say, I would rather put extra effort. Yes, I would rather put extra effort to make my students excellent in English. So this will be my key words, Nisa. Why only short words, Nisa? Because they need to spend 2 minutes. Mm-hmm. 2 minutes, guys, to draft your paragraph. Mm-hmm. So without a draft, you will never go wrong. If you do not have a draft, Nisa, they will have that creak, creak, pause moment.
Yes.
When they start to write, halfway, they'll be like, creak, creak.
That
creak,
blank
creak.
Moment.
Yes, that blank moment. Mm-hmm. So now, what we are going to do now is look at the colors. So this is yellow, this is red, and this is green.
Green.
So now, what we are going to do is, I'm going to ask the students to give me their VAs from this. So this is actually given for two paragraphs. Mm-hmm. So basically, they should have four paragraphs like I mentioned just now. Remember the playground mind map?
Yes.
So you have to be two paragraphs. Let us focus on one. Mm-hmm. So we are going to talk about why.
Why?
So the question has to be written here. Mm-hmm. So my question will be on online shopping. Why do we prefer online shopping? Mm-hmm. Okay, some of you girls may say, Madam, I'm not good in writing a good question. Mm-hmm. Can I have like grammatical errors when I write question? Mm-hmm. Yes, you can write simple words as long as you understand the idea.
Yes.
Because what matters most is not this part. This is just to trigger your idea. Mm-hmm. The mom matters most because that is how you're going to start your sentence, Nisa. Mm-hmm. So it's okay if you have grammatical errors when you write the question.
Yes, don't be afraid, guys.
Just write as long as you can understand your own idea. Mm-hmm. So this is the question. Why do we prefer online shopping? So Nisa, the first VA1 has to answer the question.
Okay.
So I want you to choose any one of them to decide.
I'd like to choose Sharifah. Sharifa.
Okay.
Sharifa, can you answer this one?
Do you want to answer the first question?
Yes, of course.
Yes, of course. Go. So how do you answer that?
Okay. Thank you, Madam and Miss Nisa. So my color is white. Mm-hmm. And white represents true story. My VAs are more options, and my conjunctions are because and so. My sophisticated adjective is overwhelm. Not to forget, I will use to plus verb. And I will be using zero conditional.
Zero conditional, the previous lesson. Okay, good. So give me your sentence.
So my sentence is, if we shop online, there are more options because we get overwhelmed searching for the item that we wanted, so it saves our time.
Good job! So Nisa, if you notice, Sharifa's answer actually started with this, shop online,
shop
because she
online.
Had the sentence, if we shop online.
Yes.
So this will be her VAs. This is shop. And this is online.
Online.
All right, so that would be Sharifa's VA. So from the VA, that was how she got her sentence. Okay, good. Now, let us go to VA5. So you have to give me the so what. So this is how it works. So if Sharifa says that she can shop online, what will happen? What will happen if Sharifa shops online? Anyone wants to answer the last VA5?
To help? I think Alia. Yes, Alia.
Okay, Alia. All right.
How can you help Alia? Sharifa?
Okay. So what's your answer?
Thank you, Madam and Mrs. Sa. So my color is blue. That represents so what and conclusion. My VAs are save money. My conjunctions are and, because, and so.
Because so.
Okay.
My adverb will be happily.
Happily.
My relative pronoun will be which.
Which. Okay. Relative pronoun. Good.
And I also will be used to worry.
To. Okay.
Okay, your sentence?
And my sentence is, we save money because we can compare the prices before buying, which is sold at a wholesale price.
Wholesale price.
So, we can do shopping happily and not to worry about the cost.
Very good job, you can shop happily without worrying about the cost. That's good. So now let's go to the next one.
I agree with you, Alia.
So the last one is always blue, yeah? Mm-hmm. So the third one will be yellow. So can I have the yellow in the house, please? Mm. Give me your answer. Go.
Okay, Fatin.
Yes.
Positivity.
Thank you, Miss Nisa and Madam. Mm-hmm. My colour is yellow, mm-hmm. which represent positivity, benefit and advantages.
Yes.
And then my VAs are avoid physical contact.
Okay.
My conjunctions are because, so, and. Mm-hmm. My relative pronoun is who.
Mm-hmm. Who.
My phrasal verb is hold back. Mm-hmm. My adjective is satisfied.
Okay. Satisfied.
And I will use to post.
Two posts, okay?
Two posts, okay.
All right, give me your sentence, dear.
So, my sentence is, online shopping can avoid physical contact because we have agent to post the item to the customers who will receive it, so they will not hold back and are satisfied with the purchased item.
Good.
Okay,
this is so true story.
Yes.
Okay, good. All right, now let's go to the next one. That is, what's next? What's color? All right.
Red.
We have red color. So can I have red color in the house, please? Give me your VAs.
Okay, Nicole.
Anyone wants to answer red color? For red color feelings?
Me, madam.
Iriani. Okay. Oh, okay, Iriani. Okay, over to you, Iriani.
Thank you, Madam and Miss Nisa. Mm-hmm. My color is red, which represents feelings and emotions. Mm-hmm. My VAs are feel radiant.
Feel radiant.
My conjunctions are because and. Mm-hmm. My adverb is wisely. Mm-hmm. My phrasal verb is pace off.
Pace, okay. Mm-hmm.
My relative pronoun is which.
Which.
And I will use to by.
To. Oh, you got to be by. Okay, to by. Okay. Give me your sentence, Iriani.
So, my sentence is, we will feel radiant because we spend our money to buy things we want wisely, which is a self-reward after working hard for it and it pays off.
Yes, it pays off when I have my professional condenser microphone. Okay, now that concludes the red color. Mm-hmm. So we have another two more colors to go. All right, that would be
green.
Okay, so can I have somebody who can give me your idea on green color? Mm-hmm.
Green. Me, madam.
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you, madam and Miss Nisa. My VA is are unable to control temptation.
Okay, semi-model verb. Okay, that's good.
My conjunctions are and because.
Okay, and because.
My adverb is forcefully. Mm-hmm. My phrasal verb is taken away. Mm-hmm. And I will use two parts.
Okay. Two parts, okay. All right, give me your sentence.
My sentence is, we are unable to control our temptation to part with our device because it is addictive and can unhealthily captivate our eyes unless it is taken away by our parents from us.
Yes. Wow. So parents out there, please take away your children's gadgets and devices.
No.
Okay, good job, Sarah.
I have
Sarah.
So many things in my car.
All right, now we shall proceed to the next color. What color is that? We haven't done... Who has not given me your VAs?
I think it's Nicole.
Oh, yes. Yeah, Nicole. Okay, so what color would you like to choose, Nicole?
Thank you, madam. Mm-hmm. My color is white.
Oh, white. True story.
And true story.
Okay. True story.
My VAs are love purchasing online.
Love purchasing online. Okay.
My conjunctions are and or.
And or, okay.
My adverb is regularly. Mm-hmm. My phrasal verb is brings out.
Brings out, okay.
I will use by.
By.
So my sentence is, mm-hmm. the most significant reason for people who love purchasing online regularly mm-hmm. is due to the convenience mm-hmm. it brings out to people mm-hmm. by the dealers, and especially when stores are having an ongoing sale mm-hmm. or promotion.
Wow, okay.
This is very, very
true. I can see
true.
The difference between girls' and boys' sentences. Do mm-hmm. you agree with me?
Yes.
The girl sentences are like quite more quality and mm-hmm. impressive.
Mm-hmm. But maybe because we shop online all the time.
So this is very near to them.
Yes.
So they cannot stop writing
something
when they start
that
doing
we
it.
We can really relate to our daily
yes.
life. So how about my friends at home? Are you guys following? I think everybody's like, okay, I need to combine all these words to make sentences to make sure that it's all well constructed. And let's take a break. I'll give you guys some time to get your sentences done. And I'll see you guys after this in Teras Didik TV KPM.
Didik TV KPM. Didik TV KPM.
Thank you for those who are still watching Teras Didik TV KPM. So far, we have learned how to construct sentences, a very well-constructed sentences. We've combined words, adjective, noun, proverbs, conjunctions, and so many things. And our friends have given their ideas. So let's see what we have done just now.
All right. Okay, girls and boys, now you must be wondering, mm-hmm. how could the girls write such a long sentence?
Yes.
So this is how the process starts, yeah? Mm-hmm. Okay, now, first up, you need to choose the colour, just like what your friends did just now.
Mm-hmm.
And you have to go to your VA, which is your jantung, Nisa.
Yes.
Remember the first lesson that I taught you?
The
okay.
heart.
Yes, the jantung, that is your VA. Now, the second step is you need to add on, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Because the words that you have here is very simple, you see?
Yes.
Feel radiant. So it doesn't stop there. So you have to add in more words
mm-hmm.
to make it more content. It has mm-hmm. weight there, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And then you will go to your step four, that is your subject. Now, Nisa, this goes to the first few weeks of training.
Mm-hmm.
But eventually, later on, they don't need this box anymore.
Yes.
They don't need this step.
It's
they
all can in just, their
Yeah, they can just write
mind.
Flawlessly, all right? So step four will be doing the subject.
Mm-hmm.
And then, when they go to the next column, they have to always ask their son, they have to always ask themselves, what's next? What is the next color? What is mm-hmm. the next color? So let's say you have to choose green.
Green.
Now, when you know that's green, you should always add in your modal verb or semi-modal verb.
Mm-hmm.
But to make it easier for some students out there, always start with your conjunctions. Because conjunctions is the best helper to make students grow. What's
mm-hmm.
next? Yeah? Okay. Now, step seven is you complete your words under your green color box. And when you go to the next one, again, you have to ask yourself the same question, Nisa.
What color?
Which color?
Mm-mm.
What color do I want to choose? So it can be white, it can be any colors, Nisa.
Mm-hmm.
So let's say it's yellow. So yellow means it has positivity.
Positivity.
So again, you have to start with conjunctions.
Mm-hmm.
And the process goes on and on and on. So meaning, girls and boys, your complex sentence actually has three colors.
Mm-hmm.
You never know, you never notice. So this is the time for you to know about that. All right, now let me just give you an example. So, okay, again about me, VA. Has taught English,
mm-hmm.
so I'm going to add on for 24 years in 11 schools.
Ooh.
So then I will have my subject, Madam Faraliza. So I'm going to go to the next one. So what color? I'm going to choose red.
Red.
So how do I feel? I'm going to have my conjunctions, and it will start with Anne. She is blessed to have a supportive family. And what's next? I'm going to use yellow. So what mm-hmm. is the positivity about Madam Farah in the sentence?
She's
I'm
going
to use my
fun.
Conjunctions. So she can share her skills to others on mastering the language. So
mm-hmm.
this is how the process works. Yeah, because Nisa, all students, they have different abilities of writing.
Mm-hmm.
Those who speak the language at home,
right.
whose mm-hmm. medium is in English, they have no problems, but they still have to make sure in one sentence
mm-hmm.
should have three colors.
Yes.
So look at all the sentences just now. So this is actually the result, Nisa,
mm-hmm.
from all the sentences given by your friends just
mm-hmm.
now. So this is sentence number one, sentence number two, sentence number three, number four, number five, number six. Madam, are we supposed to write six sentences in one paragraph? No, it's all about your timing.
Mm-hmm.
If you can write very fast, hit it until 6. If mm-hmm. you can't do it, make it 4. 4 is the minimum requirement of a standard paragraph, Nisa. Mm-hmm. Yeah? But no matter how, no matter what amount of word sentences they can give, mm-hmm. it has to be 3 colours in one sentence. Mm-hmm. All right? So this will give you a 1 complete paragraph. I still remember, Nisa, my students, like maybe 5 years ago, mm-hmm. when he writes a paragraph, he writes until 11 lines.
11 lines?
11 lines with a standard size of font.
Wow.
So what makes him do that? Because mm-hmm. he's used to mm-hmm. write long sentences. Mm-hmm. And when you can write this in form 3, you will make wonders when you go to form 5.
Ah, everybody will be so impressed.
A plus will go to you. A plus will go to you mm-hmm. in no time. So one paragraph should have minimum 4, maximum 6. Mm-hmm. And they need to spend 7 to 10 minutes in one paragraph.
For one paragraph actually
wraps up on how SVA works mm-hmm. with your dad in the question.
Yes.
And with your mom as your draft. And each bubble, mm-hmm. you need to spend 2 minutes.
2 minutes.
1, 2. Mm-hmm. So that is why I always tell you in the first lesson, mm-hmm. I will have my bell.
Yes.
And they will have this book. Ah. So this book is a must, Nisa. So every time when I have my face-to-face classroom, mm-hmm. so I'm going to start using this. So they're going to write mm-hmm. all their bubbles.
Yes.
And this is what they will bring in the examination hall, Nisa. Ah. They'll bring the keywords.
The keywords.
They mm-hmm. don't bring the whole essay. They'll yes. bring the keywords. And girls and boys, you will also use this not only in examinations, mm-hmm. but when you go for interviews.
Ah, there must be fun to have to impress people with your great words, long sentences, all well combined and well constructed. So thank you so much, Madam Farah. I have so much fun for today's lesson. Bells and our friends, do you guys have fun? Yes, if yes, give me double thumbs up.
Tepuk, yeah. tepuk. Good job. Good job.
Good job.
Good job.
Good job.
Good job.
Good job.
Good job, girls.
And good job to our friends at home for staying until the end of the show because we learned so much today and it's time for conclusion, Madam Farah.
Okay, thank you, Nisa. So our conclusion is definitely it answers our objective. Yeah, the first one was students are able to organize and develop their ideas from their mom with VAs. Mm-hmm. And they were also able to produce one draft because mm-hmm. of the time constraint.
Yes.
So instead of 2 drafts, they were able to only complete 1 paragraph. Okay. So that concludes our lesson for today, Nisa.
Yes. Thank you so much, Madam Farah. If any of you guys out there missed this class, don't worry, you can rewatch this episode on Didik TV KPM's YouTube channel. Just search Bahasa Inggris with Madam Farah Liza, you'll find the video. Okay, so it's time to sing.
Yes.
Definitely with the song, with lyrics that Madam Farah prepared for us today. And I'll see you guys in the next episode of Teras. My name is Misake. Thank you so much, my friends. Thank you, Madam Farah. Bye.
It's all about technology. And I'm warning you, this is live from Madam Farah Liza.
Yes.
Go, Nisa. I'm warning
you.
So freeze your hands
cause you're all tied up.
I'm warning
you.
So freeze your hands cause you're all tied up. You seize on it when you wake up.
You play it hard and fast
cause you have everything. You turn on games, you miss your class. But easy come and easy go
never ends.
Time to run, Madam Farah.
You trick and jump and let it grow. I hit on you, I'm warning, cause I don't want you to fall through.
Yeah, yeah. Ta-ta-ta-ta. I'm warning you.
So freeze your hands cause you're
all tied up.
I'm warning
you.
So freeze your hands cause you're all tied up. I need you to understand. I try so hard to get it right. The kind of life you want in the end. Only then can you begin to live again.
An empty shell you used to be. The reason of my life was hanging over me. You hit the skids,
but you don't know. won't even send the devil down to make it out. What I'm doing, what I'm chasing, what about them, what the makeup, what we got, good vibes, don't embrace it. What the feel for the need to replace your class. You continue. I can't do the rapping part.
Yeah.
Oh, no, okay. Okay.